the moisture out of the beef. But what we're going to do is cook this in direct heat. We're also going to have some grilled vegetables and grilled corn. That's going to be really good tonight. I'm going to start this. It'll probably take about an hour and a half. You want the internal temperature of this to be roughly around 150 degrees, 145 to 150. That'll be lightly pink on the inside. So we're going to get this started in just a few minutes. Okay, got our coals ready here, and you see how I've got them piled around the side. We're going to cook this in direct heat. I'm going to throw some apple wood on there to get a little bit of smoke flavor in it. We're going to get this roast on the road. It's going to be good. Okay, so we're going to slap it on here. I got water under it. Got a pan of water, and that's what you want. You want to keep a lot of moisture in this heat. Get it away from the fire as much as possible. A little bit later, I'm probably going to wrap it up with some aluminum foil and cook it about a half hour. But you want to try to get the, you know, as much of the dry heat off of it as you can. So we're going to get some applewood chips here. And remember, we're not smoking this. We're just putting a little smoke flavor into the meat, but we're not going to actually do a slow smoke. So, get that on there. Closed up. There we go. About an hour, hour and a half, this thing will be ready. What I've done here is cut up some vegetables. I got some yellow squash. I got some red bell pepper. Got some asparagus, and I got a piece of corn here that I've wrapped up in aluminum foil. We're going to throw that on the grill too. You can cook it in the shuck, but you would need to soak it in water for a couple hours before putting it on there. You're going to have to turn it off. Then what I'm going to do after the roast is done is, while it's resting, is I'm going to come in here and I'm going to saute this onion, this garlic, and these bay leaves with red wine sauce. And we're going to reduce that down to kind of give a little bit of a dipping sauce to the beef that I'm cooking. You can put barbecue sauce on it if you want. That's up to whoever's cooking the roast. But we're going to go out and get these things started here in just a minute. I've wrapped this in aluminum foil. I wanted to get the heat off the outside of the beef and just kind of let this thing cook in this aluminum foil for a little bit. It will kind of burn the edges if you're not careful. That's why you want to try to keep any heat off the side of it. Turn it off and spritz it with water, and that's what I've been doing. This is going to be good. When I bring it inside, we're going to let it rest for about 15 minutes before we cut into it. Okay, we're out here getting ready to do the vegetables. I got them on the grill here. And what we're going to do, this is called a vegetable wok, or you can put shrimp in here. You can mix these vegetables with smoked sausage, whatever you want. Just got to kind of keep turning them. The same with the corn, just every once in a while turn it over. And this is, these things just come out good. Don't worry if you get a little scorch edges, that just adds to the flavor, really. This is what you're doing is grilling them. You're not indoor cooking them on the stove. So we're going to do this for a little while. This is going to be a great addition to what I'm cooking tonight. So I'm sauteing the onions and the garlic and the bay leaves. And I'm going to put some of the juice from the roast in here shortly, and we're just going to put a little bit of wine and let it simmer down, thicken up a little bit, and that'll be our kind of all juice. Never waste this stuff, but we're gonna take it out of the liquid itself whenever I get ready to eat and use it. So it's gonna look good. A few more minutes, we'll be eating. Hey, this is it. Grilled vegetables, grilled corn, grilled sirloin tip roast, even some of that fine sauce that I made. So I'm going to ask blessing and get into eating this, man. It's going to be good.